Alright, what's up YouTube? So, my next project after the Hooligan Mod is going to be replacing the handlebar switches. And the switches I'm going to be replacing, obviously, are the left and right ones. The left handlebar switch being the headlight, turn signal, horn switch, and the right being the kill switch slash starter button. Alright. So what I'm going to be switching those out with is, we'll start off with the right bar side, this little guy. This guy is going to go in place of the kill switch on the right handlebar. And as you can see, it's only one button, so obviously the power button is going to go somewhere else, and it's going to be going on the left handlebar switch. But anyways, so this little guy is going to be going on the right, which is going to really take down a lot of space, obviously, as you can see. This guy got off Amazon for a couple bucks. Don't know how it's going to work, but we'll see. If not, I only lost a couple bucks, and I can redo it later if need be. All right. So, now that I got this out of the way, the second switch I'm going to be doing, obviously, is left handlebar switch. And what I'm going to be replacing it with is this little guy that I got off Amazon also. Now what it is just like this one. It's almost the exact same kind of setup. It's headlight up top, lows, highs, left turn signal, right turn signal, middle, and a horn button, just like this one. But as you can see, it's size-wise about the same height, but it's probably, I don't know how well that can be seen, a little bit thinner. So you're not taking much away here, but the advantage here is what I'm going to be doing since I do not have a horn on my bike. I took it off, never used it really, and I live in a small town, so the horn's not a big deal. The start button is going to be going over here on the left side, which is going to be a little weird at first getting used to, but it should be... Alright, and it also makes kind of a stealth thing, so if somebody tries to steal your bike, they'll probably be pressing the kill switch, and they won't think to press the horn button to start it. So, other things that you're going to need besides your two switches, which are right here, are some black electrician's tape, the appropriate, I guess appropriate is a horrible word, the... correct, I do believe they're called Mishimoto connectors, male, female, and you get these off of, I got these in bulk, there's about 100 here, Eastern Beaver. I'll put a link in the description. It's a guy out of, it's Canadian, a man out of Japan doing this, and from what he sent me after I ordered from him, the shipping was really fast, got here in like 6 days from Japan, which I was impressed by, and the connectors look just as good as OEM quality, so I'm sure they are actually OEM quality probably, but anyways, you need the Mishimoto correct connectors. Other things that are optional, well, I guess I don't have them right in front of me, but you're going to need a good pair of wire crimps to be able to crimp these and kind of take wire off as you need, or unsheathe wire. I don't have those in front of me, but a good pair is always recommended whenever doing any kind of electrical work. Now, optional things you could use. Soldering iron. Right here I have a butane powered one. It's a 2-in-1 butane torch and soldering iron. Works pretty good. This is for whenever you make these crimps, dropping a little bit of solder on the crimp connections. That way they don't kind of wiggle free or break free as easily. Just kind of added insurance, kind of a more proper way to do it. Obviously, solder. Another good thing to have is some kind of pick tool. Now, this is the wrong pick tool. I didn't want this one. I wanted one that kind of just comes out. But what they're for is when messing with these, I don't know what the heck you call them, little blocks or anyways, where you stick your wires and your connectors into, it's really... you don't want to just try and yank wires out because they will not come out because they're locked in there by a small little clip. And these work really well, much better than a small screwdriver. at being able to get in there and kind of pick that clip up so then you can pull it out nice and easy without putting any kind of stress on your wires. So, optional but highly recommended is a pick of some sort. Doesn't have to be two-sided. These are super cheap. Got it at the Ace bargain bin. I got a whole set of them for super duper cheap, like $2, I think. Another thing that's optional, but it's always nice to have if you do any kind of electrical work, I found out, are these, I don't know what to call it. It's these gator clips here with a magnifying glass. And what it does is it's able to hold your, especially when doing any kind of soldering job, it makes it so much easier because you put your wires in the gator clips, soldering iron in your right hand. You don't have to kind of jerry rig anything up. And the magnifying glass is just for old blind geezers. Just kidding. And, you know, you can get your solder, bam, 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 done. Unclip it, and yeah. When doing any kind of wiring work, I found that it's much easier to use this than to try and not use one. That's a horrible way to say it. But anyways, yeah, you get what I'm saying. It's better to use one of these than to try and jerry-rig stuff up. This is my next project, and I will try and get the Hooligan Mod, the rest of that video out for you. The original video I shot was kind of crappy, and I was shooting it while I was doing the project, which made it really not so great. Now that I'm completely done with it and taking it apart and put it back together, that I got it, it should be a lot better once I take it apart and put it back together. It should be much smoother, better video than what I have currently. So I'll try and get that out at some point. So anybody who's curious about the Hooligan Mod, and let me just say this, I put about 400 miles on the Hooligan Mod wheels since I put them on, and I absolutely love them. So anybody who's on the fence about it, it's a cheap enough thing that I would go ahead and start collecting parts for it and looking for different sets of wheels, kind of what fits or what, you know, might fit and what you like. So anyways, that's my update on the Hooligan Mod and my next project, which is switches. So thanks for listening to this boring ass video. Don't forget to comment, subscribe, like, talk shit, it don't matter. See ya.